You are about to see the most incredible doll ever invented. Her name is Poppy, and she is the first truly intelligent doll in the world. A little girl can talk to her. Poppy gives her answers. She is the first doll actually able to have a conversation with a child. Hard to believe? Just watch.
As lovable as a real girl. And she talks like one, too.
Hi, my name is Poppy. I love you. Can you help me polish my shoes?
Why, of course, Poppy. Just like a real girl, Poppy always wants to look her best.
Perfect. Thank you.
Her hair is sturdy and won't come out when you brush it, and smells just like a poppy flower. Is there anything else you'd like to say, Poppy?
I'm a real girl, just like you.
What's the time?
Playtime!
And if you've ever wanted to see how all of the nation's favorite toys were created, Playtime Co. is now offering factory tours at just $2.99 a person. An entire hour in the most magical toy factory on Earth. What are you waiting for? Come visit the factory. We can...
You opened my case.
Having fun. The new Mommy Longlegs from Playtime Co. What's the time?
I promise I won't bite.
Just trying to get the power back on. Here.
I wanted to thank you for freeing me. I was stuck in there for so long. Thank you. I'd like to pay you back. There's a train station nearby. It needs a code, and I have it. We're gonna get out of here. As soon as you get on up here... Come on. I'm up here. I see you. I should be able to follow you through the vents. This way.
Listen, I'm going to need you to trust me.
I know when your birthday is. June 28th.
It's a wish.
Welcome to Musical Memory. This advanced memory and cognitive recognition test is designed to stimulate several segments of the brain, allowing us to see how quickly and efficiently your brain works. A sequence of colors will be shown, and you must recreate the exact sequence using the buttons around you.
Bunzo will slowly lower towards you.
When you complete a color pattern correctly, Bunzo will rise back up. When you input a pattern incorrectly, Bunzo will lower towards you faster. If Bunzo reaches you, your test is over. The test will become more difficult as it continues, with longer patterns in quicker succession. That's all. Good luck.
Isn't it amazing? Mommy hasn't seen the place up and running in years. Mommy can only imagine how excited Bunzo must be. It's been such a long time since he's been able to play, to cheer, to eat. Oh, that's the dinner bell. Good luck.
Round 5.
Oh, it broke. That's no fun. We're doing such a splendid job. Mommy has decided to give you part of the code for the train. Look up. Mommy was hoping the game could last a little longer. It's okay, though. Mommy knows other ways to play with you.
Told you that herself. Our next game is Wag-a-Wuggy.
This advanced test is designed to assess the extent of your reactionary abilities. A dual palm grab pack will be provided to you for this test. Around you are 18 sizable holes. An adorable Huggy Wuggy toy could appear out of any one of these holes. If one comes out, hit it with your grab pack. That's all. Good luck.
The toys in this game used to have strings attached to them, so they could pull back when they got too close to the children. Have fun. Children. It's never too late to change your mind.
The button to feed me candy.
Thank you. You're so good. Seems like you're ready for the final game, statues. Follow Mommy down the stairs one last time. I hope you had a fun day at the game station. See you next time.
Welcome to Statues. This advanced obstacle course is designed to test your physical endurance and strength. The rules are simple. The lights will turn off. You can move through the obstacle course at this time. However, when the lights turn on, you can look around but cannot move. You may move again once the lights turn back off. The lovable PJ Pugapillar will follow you. If PJ reaches you, your test is over. That's all. Good luck.
It was always so sad to see the kids go. They called me Mommy because I was the closest thing they ever had to one. But they come for games and never come back. They left Mommy to die alone.
Mommy didn't deserve that.
But you worked here. So if anyone deserves to die alone, it's you.
Thank you. Thank you. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Thank you.
board the train. We need to leave.
Thank you. Miss Harper, please explain the situation. Spare no detail.
Well, luck in and out. All the children were getting sleep. It was peaceful, quiet. Catnap had the red smoke in the room. Then suddenly, there was this scream. Nightmares happen, I know, but this... I mean, dilated pupils and quivering lips. The way her eyes darted around the room, and I swear, her hand and mine, it felt like her blood was boiling beneath her skin. She saw something, too. Something horrible. She... I'm sorry. I don't mean to.
Miss Harper, we'll provide the very best care we can offer. You have my word. But this is important. Did Marie happen to describe what she saw?
Yes. A monster, she said. Said that it was colorless. Gosh, I could feel the poor little heart pounding. For her, it was right there. And her movements, they were so wild. Arms flailing, legs kicking. I wanted to talk to her, see how she's doing. I really need to hear her voice right now.
That would not be advised, Miss Harper. There are many concerns we must address at this time. But vitals show normal, and we'll continue to monitor. She'll be okay.
No! Well, pardon me if I'm not comforted by that! Bring my little girl back to me!
I'm Bubba Bubbafint! Hey! I remember you! An elephant always remembers. Want to know what I remember about you? I'm Bubba Bubbafint. Hey, I remember you.
Chicken! Wanna go outside and hang out?
It's looking pretty bad outside. I've never been outside before. Will you come with me? I'm scared. Here, follow me. I'll step out first.
Today, what one thing do you think it needs more of? I asked around once. Money, I never have enough. Understanding, I can never get any. Faith, the common man has lost it. Each answer was different, and I could perhaps see some little truth in each, but I think each was also missing something. Something simple. You see, not one of them could muster a smile. A smile is hope. A smile is love. A smile is understanding. And there is nothing more gratifying to my soul than being the reason for a child's smile. To be the spark that ignites all their hopes and dreams. For it is only through hopes and dreams that we may create a better world. One where our children need not be afraid. One where they are protected. After all, this company and its toys are nothing without them. These children deserve to smile, they deserve to love, and they deserve a safe home. That is why it is with enormous pleasure that as the founder of Playtime Co., I announce... Playcare! Our very own on-site orphanage. But it's not only that. It's a school, a playhouse, a place to belong. Our very own ecosystem beneath the surface, dedicated in every inch and detail to ensuring a child's smile. It's teachers and counselors, mothers and fathers, until such a time they have all of that in you. May Playcare bring joy, inspiration, and smiles to all who enter these doors. For what gives life its meaning if not a smile?
It's me again, Ollie. Cool place, right? The kids used to live here. Now look at it. Anyways, do you see that statue in the middle of the room? Take the stairs that go under it. There's a really cool room in there that powers literally all of Playcare. I can give you a key down there.
I'm Hoppy Hopscotch. Wanna try hopping to the moon with me? Hi there, I'm Piggy Piggy. Let's eat.
Dante says, bet.
Hi, I'm Bobby Bearhug. Wanna know how much I love you?
Hey, I'm Kickin' Chicken. Wanna go outside and hang out?
I'm Bubba Bubbafint. Hey, I remember you.
Corn, can you help me with my painting?
So, you got the key. Now the question you're probably asking yourself is, where does it go? Well, head back out, and you should find a door just to the left of the cable car you took down here.
Thank you.
into the gas production zone. The beating heart of the whole evil Playcare system. All that gas you see coming from the machine is made right here in the factory. It's called the Red Smoke. Right now, it's all headed off to the right. We need to make that Red Smoke go left instead. That's how we can get to him. The machine will probably have a few dumb safeguards for you to work around, but I think you can do it. I'll call you once it's done.
Tragic news this morning. As of 9:45 a.m., local authorities report that the body of a young boy. Following recent events, Playtime Co. was asked for any comment regarding the discovery. This is what they had to say. Quote, "It's sickening. Elliot Ludwig was a great man." Get up. Get up.
Greetings, employees, and welcome to your first day here in Playtime. We're certain that in the days to come, you'll find your new family here every bit as loving and supportive as your own. Feel free to wander the halls, sit in the mess for lunch, or watch our children play and learn to their little hearts' content. Join the innovationists, where the bounds of science are continuously pushed. Or join the counselors of Playcare, whose diligence and care for our children will help shape a brighter future. Just you see. Now, every one of you has your part in that future, so should you come back tomorrow feeling unhappy for where you are or what you've done, worry not, for your supervisor is here and happy to listen. And should you come back years later, your conscience finally getting the better of you, may you descend into the dark and the dust, finding all that awaits you are incomprehensible horrors, each hungry for your return, each eager that they might find you. Perhaps they'd smile at you from a shadow, their smiling mouths full of teeth and meat and plastic, watching and waiting patiently for their turn at a warm welcome. Or perhaps they won't allow you such time to figure your place in the world you'd left, a world that's theirs now. Welcome home.
piggy piggy. Let's eat. Yes, beef. Delicious. Grilled chicken. Down the hatch. Green elephant. Yum. White unicorn. Mmm.
So hungry. Hey, what do you say you and I be friends?
Hi there. I'm Piggy Piggy. Let's eat.
Away.
2 hugs a day is better in every way.
Hugging forever. Hugs are non-stop.
I'm gonna hug you until you're done.
Hug a day keeps the monsters away.
Thank you.
This place makes her tense. I'm glad that Ollie could help you get this far. He's the reason we found you at all. Looks like the train crash hurt us both. You've been through so much. You deserve an explanation. Come on. Hey, you'll be okay. We'll be okay. You leave. What's happening down here is bigger than all of us. I need you so we can get revenge on those monsters who've tortured you, who've tortured us. You didn't act alone. They're disciples of the original, the prototype. Do the honors. Prototype knows we're coming by now. If you try to escape, he'll kill you before you ever reach that front door. He's the reason I was trapped in that god-awful case for so long. You have no idea the things he's done. Let me help you kill him. Let me help you save everyone. We've all seen you, how capable you are. You killed Huggy. You killed Mommy. You freed me. You are perfect for this. Adnep is coming. He's the final obstacle the prototype has placed against us. We can't stay here. Keep yourself safe. Ollie will call you.
you?
Yes, I remember.
You used to work here.
How are you?
Alive.
Hmm?
Barb? Oh. Barb says you're looking for your co-workers. Catnap wouldn't like that you're here. You should leave. For your own safety.
Not a good listener, are you? You're a lot like the other humans in that way. I wonder if your screams sound like theirs too. I look forward to finding out.
Hello, students. Find my sisters and I to learn facts across a variety of subjects. Did you know that there are 60,000 miles of blood vessels in the human body? The smallest bone in your body is the stapes in your ear. Still, want to learn more about human organs? Pay close attention in class. Hello, students. Find my sisters and I to learn facts across a variety of subjects.
Thank you.
Wanna try hopping to the moon with me?
All three with me. 1, 2, 3! Heh, didn't get very far, did we?
Let's just get this shipment dropped and go.
Hello, my name is Elliot Ludwig. What do you remember now?
I take it you're not a fan of this place, are you?
Nope, never liked the feel of it. I mean, don't you think these kids deserve some real sunlight instead of floodlights and painted skies? Hell, we're not even allowed to talk to these kids. Isn't that... Sorry, Stu.
Sorry? That doesn't sound like the rich I know.
Well, trying to stop being so pissed off all the time. My wife says I'm a lovely man, but I gotta control my temper. So, I'm doing it for her.
You're just different, Rich. Honest to a fault.
I love you? I love you to the moon and back. I'm crazy about you.
I'm lost without you. I've been lost a long time.
Please, you won't leave me, will you? Hi, I'm Bobby Bearhug. Wanna know how much I love you?
This angel come to save us. Nothing left to save. Not here. God kidnaps you, angel. Very often. A million pairs of eyes are on you now. Watching, waiting, hungry. They want nothing more than to crawl beneath your skin and eat away at you, bit by little bit. Feel what feels empty inside themselves. That thing, Catman, the prototype is his god, and this is what he does to heretics. These little toys all catnapped to avoid that very fate. And if we're told, they're fed. We try to fight it, the prototype's control. I am the last of the smiling critters. Listen to me. You need to get out of this place. You need to live. You and Poppy could fix this. End this madness. The torments. Oh, no. Oh, no. Leave me. Please. Just go. No.
Says fetch. Go, go, as far as you can. Why are you just standing there? You can't be here. You can't stay.
Right?
again. Come on in. Please, have a seat. How was your ride down?
It was, nothing like we were expecting. Mr. Ludwig's speech was... Well, it just confirms for us that you're the orphanage we want to go through.
Hey, I'm Crafty Corn. Can you help me with my painting?
Thanks.
Now, can you give me some red?
More red, please.
Huh? But we can't be out. You're hiding more red from me. I know you are.
Give it to you!
Perfect for... Oh.
What?
Well, it appears there's been some complications. Complications. What kind of... Thank you.
This.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good. You're here. And you've done it again. Possible. Just like I knew.
All wrong.
Catnap's gone. The red smoke is diverted. Everything is falling into place when it needs to be. If you were to keep going, then you deserve to have the truth. You came back because of your co-workers. You want to know what happened. And why. This is your answer. We called it the Hour of Joy. Everyone. The guilty, the innocent. Didn't matter. All that death didn't fix anything. And then, once it was all over, they dragged those corpses down below where they'd never be found. And they ate the bodies to stay alive. The prototype passed it down for this, for everything. As soon as we reach the bottom, we'll send the lift back up. Just hold tight, okay? After you! Alright. Once we hit the ground, we need to be cautious. There's something... What?
Thank you.
approaching the laboratory. The place where everyone was born. And this is the last step before the prototype. And we can finally kill him.
It was Sweet Sheep who broke the cable car. He wants to help us, but he is weak, so the prototype can take advantage of him easily. And when that happens, something happens. He mutates. He gets stronger and he will try to kill us if we weren't careful. We need to go to Play Park. There you can find a manhole next to each ride. Each one will have a clue leading us to the prototype location. Turns out the prototype has placed more things to stop us. He turned Huggy, Mommy, Boxy, Catnap, and even Kissy to K-Borgs that will serve him, help him do what he wants, and stop us from killing him. Each one of them will be in their own respective manhole next to its ride to stop them. You have to find some source of water to electrocut them as they are robots. I've prepared a cable car that is protected from Sweet Sheep and the others so you can get safely to Play Park.
Is a cable car. It's heading straight to Play Park. Now when you get there, go to the Ferris wheels manhole. For the first clue, you will keep in touch.
Eventually, they made their way into an open warehouse, narrowly avoiding...
Kissy, now we're going to rescue you. Survive. Escape while we descend. We'll be at the elevator soon. When you get down, head straight to the cable area and take the elevator up. Be careful always. We're almost in the laboratory in the mall area. Just hurry up and rescue Kissy. What's happening with the elevator?
Just take it easy. I'm sick of you guys being incompetent. Another factory is doing a better job, and you here will slowly reduce the rest time by 10 minutes daily. Come on, get to work, or I'll fire you idiots. Just rest.
Chicken, want to go outside and hang out? It's looking pretty bad outside. I've never been outside before. Will you come with me? I'm scared. Here, follow me. Step out first.
Huggy, get some rest. We'll find Kissy soon. Very good, Huggy. This way you will learn not to mess with us. Go to the pod. Ollie will call you. Huggy will take me somewhere else. We all want freedom. The prototype deserves to die for all the suffering. Go, we will catch you.
Hello. My name is Elliot Ludwig. When you look around at the world today, what one thing do you think it needs more? I asked around once. Money, I never have enough. Understanding, I can never get any. Faith, the common man has lost it. Each answer was different. And I could perhaps see some little truth in each. But I think each was also missing something. Something simple. You see, not one of them could muster a smile. A smile is hope. A smile is love. A smile is understanding. And there is nothing more gratifying to my soul than being the reason for a child's smile. To be the spark that ignites all their hopes and dreams. For it is only through hopes and dreams that we may create a better world. One where our children need not be afraid. One where they are protected. After all, this company and its toys are nothing without them. These children deserve to smile. They deserve to love. And they deserve a safe home. That is why it is with enormous pleasure that as the founder of Playtime Co., I...
Hey, I'm Chicken Chicken. Want to go outside and hang out? It's looking pretty bad outside. I've never been outside before. Will you come with me? I'm scared.
Here.
Family Time Code Security Log 0125. Entry the front lobby, reached by a known intruder.
A tale like this always starts simple. A mystery about a toy factory whose staff all vanished a decade prior. Well, almost all. It was dusk when the intruder broke into the factory. Its main lobby provided a warm welcome for all. But these days, it is an old, forgotten thing. It didn't take our lone intruder long before the first voice of the factory rose over the silence.
That's my warning. It's not too late to turn around. I just hope that you're certain whatever you're doing is worth it.
They ignored the warning, of course, stealing a Playtime Code grab pack, once used by staff and invented by the elusive company founder, Elliot Ludwig. The next creation our guest encountered was none other than Playtime mascot Huggy Wuggy. He loomed over the foyer with a wide, vacant smile. Weaker people would have left at that point, and yet, this intruder progressed down, kicking up pieces of the distant past in their descent. And this is where the fun began. Our intruder stirred one of the factory security measures, and he performed exactly as he was designed. Our intruder scrambled through ventilation ducts with Huggy not far behind. The ventilation in this place has always been a maze. It's impressive this intruder made it through at all. Eventually, they made their way into an open warehouse, narrowly avoiding a collapsing catwalk that sent our dear Huggy plummeting into the depths below. They lingered on the catwalks for quite some time.
We must forge onwards in the name of science. Who knows whoever made us understand it or not?
Eventually, they moved on into a room the public was never meant to see. It wasn't a factory floor or corporate office. This place was different. And yet, not even a hint of the missing staff. At the end of a long hall, there was a room. And inside that room, there was a glass case. Inside that glass case, a doll.